Hey guys, what's up? It's Roxanne with Black Belt Beauty. I am so stoked to introduce you to my girl, badass Jessica Pryor.
Hey everybody.
Jessica is a former MMA fighter, a Taekwondo specialist, and just an all-around Black Belt Beauty.
Wow, thank you.
Jess is going to demonstrate and teach us three highly effective moves inspired by kicking that will completely tone and strengthen your legs and your glutes. What I love about these moves is that you don't need a gym, you don't need weights, you don't need a partner. All you need is your will and something to post up against. So let's get to work.
First, Chun-Li Booty Builder. Bring your knee to chest, keep your foot sideways, extend your leg, and squeeze your butt. Next, Chun-Li Leg Raise. Keep your leg straight, foot sideways, squeeze your butt, and lift your leg. And finally, the Chun-Li combo. Stay on one side, side kick, step back lunge, front kick.
So a black belt beauty is a woman who is hitting it from all angles in her life to live within her greatest potential. From her mind to inner and outer beauty, she is all in with full commitment. Oftentimes that means that we need strategies, we need tools, we need things to really support the journey. So Jess, I have a question. I'm so curious to know, what is your most valued beauty product right now?
So I know you asked right now, however, I could pretty much do without any sort of makeup as long as I have chapstick.
Chapstick? No, I love it because there's so many things you can do with chapstick. So I don't know if you ever do this, but it's obviously great for your lips. We know that. It's great to groom your eyebrows, right? To hold them in place.
Yes.
And it's a wonderful eye gloss and highlighter.
That is so funny you said that because I usually get pretty dry lids oftentimes, especially in like the winter, fall time.
Mm-hmm.
And I will put chapstick around my eyes and to like use as pomade for my brows. It's perfect.
Black puppy.
Cuticles too.
Oh, yes. Yeah, if you can be any superhero, man or woman, who would it be and why?
So I kind of have two. When I was a kid, I loved watching the X-Men cartoons. Freaking amazing. Storm.
Yes!
Oh my gosh. Storm is the absolute best. She's from Kenya. She can control the elements. I mean,
white.
Can't get any better than that. Seriously. She's like regal. However, Korra.
Oh.
From the Airbender series.
Okay.
The Avatar.
Okay.
She's like a black belt beauty. Seriously. She's conflicted. She has a little bit of a bad attitude, but she's always striving to be her best for herself and for everybody else that she loves. And of course she has all the airbending and element powers.
I love that. I love that so much. That's so awesome. Do you have a favorite quote or mantra that helps you to stay motivated or just inspire you and give you that extra kick-ass energy?
So one thought or quote that has been really resonated with me lately that I've been seeing kind of pop up all over social media is from John Lennon, or at least supposedly thought to be from John Lennon. It was about his mom telling him that the most important thing is to be happy when he grows up.
Yes.
And that when his teacher asked him when he was a small child, what do you want to be when you grow up, he said happy.
Yes.
And they said, you don't understand the question, and you said you don't understand life.
I love that.
I love it too. However, I went ahead and looked it up. The reason I looked it up was because there was controversy if he actually said it, and it seems that it actually originated in a Peanuts cartoon strip by Charles Schulz in the 1960s.
Dropping knowledge.
At least that's what I saw, but it, you know.
That's amazing.
I love it
anyway. I had no ideas. I totally have chills on me because I love that quote from who I thought was John Lennon, but I love that. And that just really shows. I mean, she did the work, she dug, she got more information, she's curious. She is a black belt beauty.